Hello, good morning. Today is 22nd of October, Friday. I'm glad to welcome you to my class at the 303 for 2021-2022 session. In this, our first class, I'm going to provide an overview of what you are to meet in this course. Just to introduce the course to you, what you will meet, why you need to take the course in the first instance, how the course is going to be evaluated. So pay attention as I take you through what the course is all about. Introduction. So this course at the 303 is a 300 level first semester course. We are already in our third week. Wow, time is moving very, very fast, which means you have a lot to do. We've already done 2 weeks without being in class, but don't worry, we're going to make up for that. The course at 303 is a core course, and that implies that you have to register for it as a student in the Faculty of Education, and you must pass the course. Why do you need to take this course? You know that the process of testing is interwoven with the process of teaching and learning. And it seems the whole educational system is being driven by testing and evaluation. Let's take, for example, at the student level, testing and evaluation tend to influence the mode and manner by which students study, even their motivation. Let me put it across to you. A question, and I will be expecting your answers. Assuming in this course at the 303, no CA, no assessments, nothing, no exam. Be sincere with me. Will you attend classes? I'll be expecting your answers on Tuesday next week. But the reality is that testing is really very important within the educational system, even influencing the way students study, their motivation for attending classes. And you and I know that all stakeholders in education are concerned with the process and much more result of test. As classroom teachers, we are always involved in evaluating the extent to which students learn or have not learned what they are supposed to learn. That involves testing. Of course, parents are always keen concerning their children's performance, and this is usually communicated to them in forms of scores that classroom teachers have obtained from test. Not only that, administrators, guidance counselors, they keep records of students. They want to know their progress, and they use the result for various purposes. How do we get these results? Basically, from test scores and information on student performance to parents and administrators is the classroom teachers. This implies that as education students, teachers to be, you need to be exposed to a thorough understanding of the concept of test and measurement. How do you use evaluation instrument? How do you develop, especially achievement test, continual assessment? How do you get involved in scoring and reporting of test scores? These, of course, are the focus of this course, Educ 303. The goal of the course. Basically, the course is designed to expose you to basic concept of test and measurement, and to equip you with fundamental techniques of constructing, scoring, and reporting scores of achievement test. What are the requirements for the course? Very simple, but strict. To qualify to sit for examinations in this course, you have to attain 75% attendance, both in the physical face-to-face as well as the virtual contact. You're also expected to read widely. This course is not for those who cannot read. You're expected to be engaged in classroom interactions, dialogues, debates, discussions. Not only that, you cannot pass through me without some exposures to ICT. So you need a lot of data, gentlemen and lady. So registration first on the portal, shanadepoji.com.ng is mandatory. It's already there, and we're expecting deadline for submission to be tomorrow. Saturday. You are expected to fill in two forms. One will take you to the virtual classroom. We are using Google Classroom. In addition, you'll be expected to make contributions to online discussions on our virtual classroom. How are we going to go about the instruction? You already know, you're going to use dual mode, virtual, which is online, as well as the face-to-face contact. We're going to balance the two. We're going to make sure that you have varieties of opportunities for you to be involved in practicals, in certain questions, in administration questions, in interpreting and related issues. By the way, we gave you a survey. 217 of you have responded as at this morning, and it shows that, well, to a large extent, we are ready for virtual classes. The question, what is your preferred mode of instruction? 39.6% of us said, well, we would prefer half online and half face-to-face contact. That is not bad. We now have about 21.2 of us who make preference to mostly face-to-face, and 20.3 of us said, well, you prefer 100% face-to-face. Abba, in this era, I don't think this is not possible. At least in my course, it is not going to be 100% face-to-face contact. We're going to go by decision of the 39.6%. So the rest of you have to follow them. Please, it's possible. This is what this present era demands. How are we going to evaluate you? Quite a lot, a combination of ways to use in evaluating you. Just take note of them. The online registration is 5 marks. And I also say enrollment in the Google Classroom is additional 5 marks. Attendance in our virtual class is 20 good marks. Don't miss it. Physical attendance in the class, another 20 marks. Test 1, we'll be taking that in week 5. It's going to be online, 20 marks. Test 2, to be taken in week 8, it's also going to be online, 20 marks. Quizzes, we have about 5 to 6 of them, I presume. That will fetch you 25 marks. Contribution in class forum, 100 marks. End of semester examination, that is a standard, 60% of your total score. Don't miss out of this. But we need to warn, or advise, or send the note again. Students with less than 75% attendance in both physical and virtual classes may not be allowed to sit for the end of semester exam. So pay attention, be there physically, be there virtually. We ask the question, how difficult do you think course Educ 303 is? 218 of you responded and you gave me much joy. 69 of you, that is 31.7%, said, wow, the course is a walkover. So as you are concerned, it's nothing, it's not difficult. And as much as 38.1% of you feel, well, the course is fairly difficult. Only 3.2% feels the course is very difficult. That's good news. And that is also reflected in your expected grade in the course. This is surprising. 82.6% of you will be expecting to score A in the course. That is impressive. I hope you achieve that. Not only that, the remaining 17% said they are expecting B, and just a little tiny proportion of you, 1%, will be expecting C. Nobody expects to have D. Nobody is planning to fail. Please, as you are listening, can you give yourself a round of applause? I hope you're going to achieve this. It's achievable. It is possible, provided you do just a little to do. Attend the physical classes, attend the virtual classes, make your contributions in our forum. Don't joke with assignments, don't joke with quizzes. It's possible. If you pass on Tuesday, God's willing, that will be Tuesday, date is 26th of October, 2 p.m. That will be our first physical class. Hope to see you by then.